Ooh.
One, love.
Such a high toss skidding serve with backspin and side spin. It's a very difficult serve to read. Chamon couldn't even make contact.
Love, two.
Good start for the Portuguese player. Chamon is getting into the swing of things, getting accustomed to the surroundings.
Let, love, two. Let, love, two.
Back to back nets. I think the most number of nets I've seen in a row is four. Never seen more than four nets in a row. You can hit as many nets as you want if you could aim for it.
One, two.
Slow spin does the trick. The weakness of Fu Yu is definitely the backhand side. She usually just blocks with that because of the traditional penhold style.
Let, one, two.
Not someone that you're going to see hitting Fan Zhendong backhands from away from the table, Fu Yu, but she's got a skillful backhand side.
Two, two.
In the women's game, we only really see herself and Ni Xiaolian in the top 100 in the world playing with this style. Don't see any men's players now that use a penhold grip other than the modern penhold with the reverse penhold backhand.
Three, two.
Good recovery, three. Good stability there from the balanced Chong Meng. One of the hardest workers in the game. Watching her lockdown routine fitness regime through COVID was just insane how much effort she put in behind closed doors.
Four, three.
Helped to secure that Olympic gold medal. Sun Yingsha coming runner-up.
Three, five.
She's a very rhythmic player. Fu Yu is the kind of player that can break the rhythm. Sometimes you'll see her even playing kind of chop blocks coming across the side of the ball to slow the pace down, put a bit of side spin on it.
Three, six.
Nice switch down the line. Calm as you like, Chong Meng finally starting to get into some rhythm. And by finally, I mean after the first 2 points. Didn't take her too long, did it? Oh.
6-4.
Oh, what an angle there.
6-5.
Beautiful. I always find it quite funny watching Fu Yu play. Doesn't give anything away to what she's thinking. Just too good over the table. In the lead. As close as you can be in the lead. The second tie break.
5-8.
Just a slow spinny flip, five. That one. Judged the trajectory of the ball very well, Chong Meng. Hasn't hit many winners. She knows exactly what percentage she needs to play at to beat her opponents. I just can't ever remember Chong Meng having a bad loss. And by a bad loss for her would be someone outside the top 10 in the world. She's just so solid.
11,
well, I mean, look at that.
Five.
First two game points two of the game went to Fu Yu and then...
One, love.
She's not a player, Chan Meng, that hits the winners like you might see Sun Ying Sha doing. The power isn't as much, but the placement and varying things is his best, in my opinion.
Ooh!
One.
Not far off hitting the roller there. She smiles to herself, Riley. Not far off. I think it was the net clamp that stopped that from going round the net. The recovery is just too good. She's so good at playing the balls from the middle, where most players wouldn't be able to play a comfortable forehand, but the compound movement that Chan Meng makes is brilliant.
Let, one, two. Two.
Bit different from a lot of the players that have become a Grand Slam champ. She's not a Grand Slam champ because she hasn't got the world champs. She's become an Olympic champion, Chan Meng, before she's even become a world champion. It's not typically very common when that happens.
Three, two. But
her coach in the corner as well, Ma Lin, he was never world champion, but he was Olympic champion. Something that they both got in sort of similar between them.
Let.
Chan Meng and Ma Lin.
Three, two. Two. Four.
It's a zipping backhand. It's not a very hard hitting backhand, but it's more speedy. Doesn't sound too loud when she hits it because of the amount of quality she's putting on it. A lot of topspin. She brushes over the top of the ball. Not too sure what she uses on the backhand side, but wouldn't surprise me if it's either a Chinese rubber or perhaps something like a Tenergy or something else. I know she was a butterfly sponsored player, Chan Meng. Used to use the Viscaria.
Six, two.
Take a look at a racket in a sec. As soon as the camera pans to it. In fact, I think she's still using the Viscaria now. Look how high Chan Meng's thumb is when she plays a backhand. That's how she gets the control with it. If you put your thumb high on the backhand and put some pressure on your forefinger when you play a forehand, that's what the Chinese coaches recommend.
2-8.
She's just proving way too good. The combinations that she's playing. I mean, look how easy she made that look. Like taking candy off a baby.
3-8.
I think that's the only department of the game that Fu Yu has over Chan Meng. It's the serve. She can win more outright points off the serve. But in terms of that traditional pen old style, it just can't put enough pressure on Chan Meng to hit it past her or to block it deep enough, consistently enough.
Then, 3.
Short topspin serve, and Fu Yu goes along with the push. Masterclass in serve. Oh, my
11,
goodness
three.
Me.
Game
it's an absolute walk in the park there in game two for Chan Meng.
Love, one. Two.
It's just so swift. Doesn't seem too powerful to not get back, but it's the placement. Oh, wow.
3, love.
Just not an ounce of doubt, not a second of indecisiveness. Such clarity of thought.
Love.
I was watching before this match begun, I was watching the Chinese simulation. They did the women's team against the men's team. It was really, really interesting to see.
Love, 5.
Oh, my goodness.
Two. six.
What can love. You do, Fu, with that? I mean, she's not played a shocking point there. I think she has to play down the line a little bit more. Ah. Oh. Well, out six, of all the balls, one. It's that one she misses, and she sees the humour in it, Chun Mong. I don't think Fu Yu finds any humour in that whatsoever.
2-6. Three, six.
Well, it's become that much more close. Swings and roundabouts, first to 11. Didn't take too long to win again, but didn't take too long to come back either.
Seven.
Just so much quality three. Coming from the rubbers. So much top spin. You really, your backhand has to be very closed, and because Fu Yu can't do that with her side, backhand side of the racket.
Seven.
Well, it's the same side
four.
As the forehand, but. When she plays it from the backhand side, she can't close that angle, which is why she can't block that top spin that Chun Mong is generating. It's why their style was revolutionized,
four,
why eight. Liu Guoliang knew it was necessary to implement something new with the penalty grip to help it, to save it from extinction. He invented the reverse penalty backhand. And now that's what
four,
everyone pretty much
nine.
Is using. Chun Mong is really illustrating the weakness of this traditional style.
9-5. 10-5.
Five match points for Chun Mong.
Ah. Six.
One way to save one. If I was to guess what she just said to herself there, it would be, why didn't you do that earlier? But my lip reading isn't the best, to be quite honest, especially in different languages. Chop block off the net. Nice combination
seven.
Player from Fu Yu. Timeout. Short to middle or to backhand. Let's see. Oh, short
11,
to forehand,
seven,
and the feeling from the Olympic
match,
champion secures the match.
Three,
and
zero.
She progresses through in three straight.